said something worth a shit.
Our little gray cells are
yes, thank you for those.
Excited now.
But even if that really is an N, N037 doesn't make any more sense than before.
Damn it! So use. I just don't know. He only knows Japanese. That's actually he should also know English because they teach it. But still. Okay, here we go.
Rotate the image 180 degrees.
Here's the thing. It's a tutorial quest, or excuse me, case, not quest. And everyone in chat's like, oh yeah, these are gonna get harder, so. Get ready for a mind boop. I think maybe I see something.
Oh my god. Now I see. She wrote down the killer's name.
Huh? You just shot past the clue part and right onto who did it.
So, whose name did she write?
Psychus dying message reveals the real killer's name. If you turn the message 180 degrees, it should become crystal clear.
Here's my answer.
Ooh.
The key to solving this mystery was simply to rotate the writing 180 degrees. If you turn the message around, it becomes the letters.
Oh, I remember Conan. I love Conan.
O-N. L-E-O-N. Or more accurately, Leon.
What? What the hell are you talking about? It's just a coincidence. It's just a bunch of random squiggles that happen to look like my name.
I know what's still going on.
No, it's not random at all.
It's like One Piece. It never ends. Yeah.
She wrote that message on the wall behind her as she was leaning up against it. In that position, she couldn't move to write normally and had to write upside down, as it were.
Okay, wait a minute. Was she factoring? Oh, so she was factoring in the flipping. Okay, never mind. One Piece is episode 927. Conan's like, what? 1500? 1600?
And as a result, when you look at it standing in front of her, it ends up getting flipped. Try it for yourself if you want. Write something sitting like her, and the letters will be inverted.
That sounds like one hell of a stretch to me.
Well, let me see your hands, buddy.
I'm the killer? You can't just go and say shit like that.
How's your shirt, by the way?
If you're not the killer, then why did you try to destroy the evidence?
Huh?
You know what I'm talking about, right, Makoto? The evidence Leon tried to get rid of?
Yeah, the shirt. The evidence that Leon tried to get rid of.
Burnt shirt piece I found laying on the ground by the incinerator, right?
As the killer stabbed Sayaka, they must have gotten some of her blood on them. And to dispose of the shirt covered in the victim's blood, they threw it into the incinerator.
But one piece burned off and got left behind.
976. Okay, so a little bit less than I thought, but still. Yeah.
If they had, they most certainly would have panicked. Isn't that right, Leon?
But is one scrap of fabric enough to conclude that Leon is guilty?
Well, there is also the incinerator.
I mean, Leon's
can make
not
that pitch.
The only one wearing a white button-up.
That's right. There are plenty of other people here with shirts like mine.
Censored. I don't know why.
With just that one little charred piece, there's no way you can say for sure who it belongs to.
You're right. That alone isn't enough. But there are some other points that may reveal the truth.
Are you finally starting to understand?
A little
bit. The answers to all the riddles are right here.
Yeah, I think so.
The burnt remains of the button-up shirt, which the killer wasn't able to get rid of. There's something about it we need to pay attention to in order to figure out who's responsible. How it was disposed of.
If we look closely at how the shirt was disposed of, we should be able to figure out who the killer is.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. I think I know what you're gonna say.
Which is?
You can't reach the incinerator without opening the gate in front of the trash room, right?
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, you wouldn't be able to hit the switch to turn it on, either.
Mm-hmm.
You'd need the key to get in, and the one with the key was the person on cleaning duty. So the killer had to be whoever was in charge of taking care of the trash, right?
Wrong!
Interesting.
Wait for it. No, that's wrong. There was another way to use the incinerator. That's exactly what proves that Leon is the real killer. Crystal ball. Oh god, Orizume.
The key to the trash room. Whoever was on cleaning duty must have had it, right?
So the only one who could get to the incinerator was the person in charge of the trash?
And you'd have to get close to the incinerator in order to destroy the...
No, that's wrong! Hold on!
Bring the pain, buddy. Bring the pain.
I know how someone could dispose of the evidence without using the trash room key.
But if you can't get past the gate, you couldn't possibly turn on the incinerator, could you?
Unless you're really good at pitching a baseball.
If you use this.
What is it, some kind of glass ball? It's busted to hell.
It's worth a million, too.
Actually, it was supposed to be a crystal ball, but,
But how would you use it?
The killer had to use the glass ball.
I got it!
Divine.
The killer simply took aim at the
incinerator. He used the spirits to touch them.
And threw the ball through a gap in the gate. All they had to do was hit that switch, and the incinerator would come to life.
Someone threw that through a gap in the gate?
Remember what you said before, Hifumi?
Oh, someone turned the incinerator on. Very strange. I'm quite certain it was off the last time I was down here. Perhaps it was the work of a fairy.
Hifumi had the key, so the only way the incinerator could have been turned on without his knowledge was because the killer was able to hit the switch without opening the gate. Once they'd gotten the incinerator going, all they had to do was ball up the shirt and toss it in.
Hey, come on! What the hell is this?
All you have to do is look at the scene to know that the killer never actually went inside the trash room. The shards of broken glass, the incinerator left running, the piece of shirt that escaped the fire. If the killer had been on cleaning duty, the evidence would have been taken care of much more thoroughly.
Wait, no, just hold on.
But the distance from the gate to the incinerator has to be at least 30 feet, right? The pinpoint accuracy you'd need to throw a glass ball that far and hit something that small.
Really, really.
Could someone really do that?
If they're the ultimate baseball player.
That's right! There's no way! It'd be impossible!
Difficult, absolutely. Impossible? I don't think so. Because the killer is...
It wouldn't have much of a challenge.
I got it!
Woo!
Because the killer is the ultimate baseball star. Isn't that right, Leon?
Do you have any idea how stupid you sound right now?
A target 30 feet away would surely be little challenge for the ultimate baseball star.
Oh, Toku. Oh, so Sour River. I mean, Toku... is a little sour, to be fair. Like, I kind of want to know what her backstory is, but we'll get to it, hopefully.
You can't be serious. I'm not the killer. These goddamn shipper brains have got it all wrong, I'm telling you.
Well, the facts...
You still won't admit it? Okay, then. Makoto, go ahead and review the incident one more time to make his crime perfectly clear.
Oh, is this the closing argument?
That, we can end this.
Listen to me! What the hell do you mean, end this?
Say what you want, Leon. But all the questions have been answered. And the truth has been revealed. Now here's what happened.
The closing argument is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? I would. Every case has one last element to bring the class trial to an end. This is the closing argument. In this phase, you'll give a complete summary of the case. You'll have to reproduce the flow of events for the case in the form of comic books. However, you'll notice that in the comic, there are a number of pieces missing. It's up to you to complete the comic using the provided truth panels. Also, if you take aim at a missing section and press the left mouse button, holy cow, you'll get a hint that might lead to a breakthrough. Well then, good luck and have fun! Oh my god, this is awesome! My room was the scene of the crime. The incident began when the killer entered. Oh, it's going from... Oh, okay. I was, like, really confused for a second, like... First, when Sayaka attacked the killer with a knife, they noticed something in my room. Oh, there we go. I think that's right. You go the opposite direction of America. Yeah, I completely forgot, by the way.
The killer is you!
You!
I think I better take one more look back at the case from the beginning.
Okay, for a second, I thought I screwed that up.
Last night, the killer went to the room Sayaka was
This
in.
Is pretty cool, though.
In other words, my room. From what we can tell, Sayaka invited that person there intending to kill them. She attacked them with the knife she'd taken from the kitchen earlier. But then something happened that she wasn't prepared for.
For him to defend himself?
The fake sword I put in my room and fought back. During the struggle, a strike from the sword broke Sayaka's right wrist.
No, I didn't lay out my reasoning right. I need to rearrange the events of the case. Oh. Oh, maybe it was that. Okay,
the
let's try that.
The killer is you. During the struggle, a strike from the sword broke Sayaka's right wrist.
I guess it repeats it, so that's my bad.
Ching. And that's when she lost her grip on the kitchen knife. Finding herself cornered, Sayaka panicked and ran into the bathroom. The killer went after her, but couldn't get the bathroom door open. What they didn't know was that my bathroom door got stuck easily, and there was a trick to opening it. Sayaka knew about that because I told her, but of course the killer had no way of knowing. So instead, the killer forced the door open, took the kitchen knife,
oh my god, that photo, that image is...
But with what strength she had remaining, Sayaka left a dying message. To keep the killer from noticing, she wrote it on the wall behind her. And with that, all her strength was gone. With Sayaka dead, the killer quickly began destroying the evidence. First, they took off their shirt, which was covered in their victim's blood. Then they took the lint roller in my room and cleaned up the entire area. They wanted to make sure they got rid of any trace they'd ever been there.
From here on out, there should be a rule that all lint rollers are destroyed in the incinerator, because as far as I know, you cannot destroy that, or you, it's not against the rules to destroy the lint rollers, therefore, helps out, hopefully. I don't know. I think, be able to tell at least with a little bit of hair, right?
Afterwards, the killer headed to the trash room to destroy their bloody shirt. They tried to burn the shirt using the incinerator there. But the trash room was blocked off by an especially sturdy gate, preventing access to the incinerator. So they came up with a plan to use Hiro's crystal ball, which he'd left in the laundry room. The killer managed to throw the ball through the gap in the gate and hit the incinerator switch. For any normal person, that'd be an impossible throw, but the killer had the confidence to take a shot. And that's because the killer was the ultimate baseball star. The crystal ball, thrown with absolute precision, hit the switch on the incinerator, which then quickly roared to life.
Jeez, these facial expressions.
Having destroyed the final piece of evidence, they left the area with, I imagine, a sigh of relief.
Monokuma killed Junko, which I'm more than positive that's like killing yourself. I'm thinking Junko actually is Monokuma, but I don't know yet.
The fire burnt away and fell out of the incinerator.
Oh, Junko.
The killer
okay.
Didn't notice this, and so left behind a piece of indisputable evidence.
Boo?
Isn't that right, Leon?
Babu?
It would appear that Hiro simply forgot his crystal ball in the laundry room. You went there to try and wash the blood out of your shirt, and that's where you saw it, right? Seeing the ball, you thought of a way to take care of everything.
So, Leon, do you object to anything that's been said?
Ooh, what's he gonna say?
Do I object? Hell yes, I object! Of course I do! I object, I object, I object! I mean, all of this is just a bunch of stupid theories. You need evidence. Where's the evidence? Without evidence, it's all bullshit. It's bullshit, and I refuse to acknowledge it.
Well, then, I guess this is as good a time as any to present the evidence that proves you did it. Makoto,
I believe you're in possession of that evidence.
I am. I have the evidence? Your first bullet time battle is about to begin. Yes. Whoa, what is this? Sometimes during a class trial, your opponent simply won't want to hear what you have to say. I know, 1,000,000 yen for that. When this happens, you will engage them in a head-to-head battle. We like to refer to this as the bullet time battle, aka BTB, by the way. During the BTB, you want to destroy your opponent's statements in time with the rhythm. Oh god. Match your button presses with each tempo marker as they move across the screen and reach the center. Oh god. Press the right mouse button to lock on to an opponent's statement. Okay. And then destroy the statement you've locked onto with the left mouse button as the tempo marker reaches the center. Oh, it's gonna get trippy. Use this method to deal damage to your opponents. If you can't pull it off, you'll be the one in pain. No. Do this consecutively and you'll start a combo. Keep this going and you'll initiate a tempo up. On the flip side, if you keep missing, you'll get into a tempo down situation. When the tempo changes, so does the timing for the hitting each other button. So watch out for that. Oh, I suck at rhythm games. Deal enough damage to your opponent and their weak spot statement will appear.
Final strike.
At that point, you can press the left mouse button to shoot it down with a truth bullet like any other statement. Repeat their statement with fast enough and you'll come out victorious. Just like before, if your influence gauge reaches zero or you run out of time, you fail. Well then, good luck and have fun!
When the killer removed the screws from the doorknob, they didn't use anything from your room to do it. Instead, they must have used something that belonged to them.
Use something with their own to remove the screws. Could that have been...
I refuse to acknowledge you!
The toolbox?
You're stupid! Stupid, we chose normal, stupid, for both.
Since it was my first game. Yeah. Show indisputable evidence that Leon is a killer. I need to figure it out. The moment of truth.
Where's your proof?
Me?
Not a chance. It wasn't me. Stupid. You lie! Stop talking! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance!
Okay. Please tell me I'm doing the right thing.
Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid!
Got it? No, I failed! Nobody believes me. Nobody wants to hear what I have to say.
I already have come to the end of the debate. Well then, the class trial is officially adjourned. Now it's time to reveal who's the Bakken.
Okay, I was trying to hold down the right mouse button. It appeared that the one with the most votes is Makoto. Makoto's not the Blacken. Too bad. Looks like the real killer just gets to graduate. Congratulations to them. On the other hand, everyone must be punished.
Is
it all over? What do you want? Want to give another try? Yes. Yes, I do.
I refuse to give up yet.
Okay, hang on. I was trying to hold down the right mouse button, but I couldn't seem to like target anything. Okay. Let's try this.
When the killer removed the screws from the doorknob, they didn't use anything from your. Instead,
I refuse. Stupid.
Okay, here we go. Moment of truth. Like trying to lock on.
Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance. It wasn't me. Stupid. You lie. Stop talking. Shut up. Here's your proof. You kidding me? Not a chance. You lie.
Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid! You lie! Stop talking! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! You lie!
Oh my god, that was...
Where's your proof? This should prove it.
Okay, yeah, I think I get it. You can target it more than once. I can only do it once. Okay, that's the thing. You don't hold it out, you just target... Okay,
the screws on the bathroom doorknob were removed.
Yeah, my brain was just like, I'm not getting that.
I wonder what kind of tool the killer used to remove it.
I mean, it had to be a screwdriver, right?
That was poorly done on my part.
I'm sure the toolkits we got each had one inside.
And that must be what he used. There aren't any other tools anywhere.
But the toolkit in my room had clearly never been used.
That's because the culprit didn't know it was your room. They thought they were in Sayaka's room.
Only the boys got toolkits, so the killer naturally assumed there wouldn't be one in there.
Okay, then whose toolkit did the killer use?
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
It had to be their very own toolkit.
I take it he's having issues right now.
Stupid, 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 stupid!
We broke him, I'm sorry.
Leon, would you mind showing us your toolkit? If I'm right about this, then the screwdriver will show some evidence of being used.
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
Huh? And if you say you used it for something else, you'll have to explain exactly when, where, and why.
And let me say this right now. I lost it isn't an excuse at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Stupid. Stupid.
So, what is his death?
So, you have no rebuttal?
What is his execution?
Then it would seem we are finished here.
Wow, they seem so passive about it. Results! I got an A? No, no. Okay, that C, the last one, makes a lot more sense. Ooh, that's how you get coins. Okay, now that makes more sense.
Looks like you've reached your verdict. Then are we ready to cast our votes? You all have a lever in front of you. Use it to make your selection.
And if one of you tries to pick me...
Just to remind you all, make triple sure you vote for someone. You wouldn't want to be punished for something so minor, right? Okay, then let's get excited!
Who I found a few when I was examined. I just couldn't figure out if like, I could get more.
Or the dreadfully like, wrong one. What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
Who is found guilty? Oh my god, this is messed up. Oh! I think I found my stinger for the game, chat.
Woohoo! Looks like you got it right. The blacken in this case is the one that killed Sayaka. Was none other than Leon Kuwata.
Stupid.
Huh? Hey, hold on.
Hold on a second. Leon, did you really kill Sayaka?
But...
I don't believe it.
You son of a bitch!
What the hell's wrong with you?
I didn't have a choice.
It was kill or be killed.
So, that's why...
I killed her first?
None of you are any different!
One wrong step and you'd be the one standing here. It was complete chance that I wound up like this.
I was just... unlucky. That's all.
Yeah.
Hey, come on!
Expect you to just accept my death?
Uh-oh.
Everything's become clear. The decision we made was right after all. But when I think about that, honestly, I'd be better off if we'd been wrong. Because if what we came up with really is the truth, then that truth is that Sayaka was trying to frame me. But even if that's true, I can't say she was wrong. After all, the mastermind... because of that video. Even I couldn't handle what I saw in there. I was her, and the video actually had been something to do with me. Can't even imagine. Now we're trapped here with no way out. They're probably waiting for me.
Why?
Can't afford to be stuck in here? The one thing that was more important to her than anything else, her dreams, her friends, to have to see something like that happen to them. Heck, did whatever it took to reach that dream. I mean it, even if some things that weren't so pleasant. That's why Sayaka, for the friends that meant so much to her, that's why she betrayed me. So when she said,
"No matter what happens, please always be there for me. I need you on my side."
She was lying to me from the very beginning. She was using me. Is that why she talked to me to the first place? I guess I'll never know. I guess there's nothing I can do to ask her what she was thinking. Mr. Dead, that's it.
Boy, howdy. The entertainment industry must sure be terrifying, huh? I mean, to try and kill someone just because of those relationships.
Ba-bum, ba-bum.
She seems so nice and lovely on the outside, but inside, she's descended into pure madness.
What'd you say?
I understand, really, I do. Yep, yep. You're in utter despair thanks to Sayaka's betrayal, right? Compassion, intimacy, love. The stronger those feelings, the stronger the despair when they collapse.
Stop screwing with us! This is all your fault. Sayaka being forced to do something like that. All of it, everything! It's all your fault. Suddenly in a frenzy, I lunged at Monokuma. But...
that's enough.
Okay.
As angry as I was, Kayoko flashed onto my arm without hesitation. Her grip was like iron, strong enough I was sure it would leave a bruise.
Calm down.
If you really want to make her enemies pay for what they've done, you need to let it go for now. Damn it!
Ba-bum, ba-bum.
Ah, that was a close one. I thought for sure you were gonna give me a good walloping. Just barely avoiding punishment, you did.
Yes, indeed.
Now then, since you so magnificently revealed the identity of the killer during the class trial, the blackened Leon will receive his punishment.
Punishment? You mean execution?
Ooh.
Wait a second!
I didn't have a choice, I had to kill her!
Yeah, that's it.
I was just protecting myself in the heat of the moment. It was self-defense.
Is that okay?
How exactly was it self-defense?
Hmm.
When you forced your way into the bathroom, did you or did you not use your very own toolkit? After she shut herself in the bathroom, you went out of your way to head back into your own room. Then you came all the way back, broke into the bathroom, and killed her. Am I wrong?
Do you understand?
You had any number of chances to stop what you were doing, but you chose not to. Is it not because you had an unclouded intent to commit murder?
So,
that's not. Stop it. I've had enough of this.
Oh.
Oh, are you sure? You were closer to her than anyone, were you not? All right, Kitsune, you take it easy. Tomorrow we'll be probably playing more of this, just FYI. He killed your precious Sayaka, do you understand? I can't say Leon is solely to blame. Of course, I don't plan on blaming Sayaka either. Because the one to blame is him. So what? If it weren't for you, this never would have happened to Sayaka or Leon. We shouldn't be fighting each other. We should be fighting against the one who put us in this situation, the mastermind.
Oh, did you awaken your sense of justice?
Hey,
well, it just so happens that there's nothing more unethical than an unwavering sense of justice. After all, it's people with that sort of mentality that perpetrate war all over the world.
Hmm.
Is that the kind of justice that awakens within you?
Shut up!
Hmm.
Well, okay. Anyway, more importantly,
kills,
let's hurry
kills,
up and get to
kills.
What everyone's been waiting for, the punishment.
I'm begging you, please don't do this.
Hey,
no more begging.
Come on now.
No more excuses. You must pay the penalty for breaking the rules. Society demands it.
Stop, please.
Now then, I've prepared a very special punishment.
The ultimate baseball, sir?
No.
Let's give it everything we've got.
This is pretty messed up. Is he gonna get hit by a baseball? Leon has been found guilty. Time for the punishment. Is this actually happening? Oh god, is he gonna get pelted by balls? Yep. Death by bludgeoning? And we have to watch? Okay, for sure nobody would want to commit murder after that, right? Like, no matter what you saw. Right? Right? What we saw was the truth based in despair. I mean, you can't call it that. What else would we call it? And my adrenaline is pumping right out of control. What's going on?
I can't take it.
We really have to keep doing this?
Well?
If you don't like it. All you gotta do is swear to cut all ties with the outside world except living here forever. That's only if every single one of you can get on board with that.
Damn you!
What are you doing all this evil shit to us?
What the heck?
Evil? You make it sound like I'm on some dark, awful, secret society type of guy.
Say what?
In this case, a dark, awful, secret society type of bear.
Well...
So why are you putting an upstanding young citizen like me through such a grueling ordeal?
Hey,
Seems like you're trying to use common sense to make sense of something that doesn't make sense. It's like trying to put a mile on a scale. I just don't think it's possible. So, I don't think what you're saying and what I'm saying quite fit together.
Shit.
You piece of shit. I don't know who you are, but I'm gonna pound your ass into the ground. You must really hate me to get so angry. But if you do that, you're barking way at the wrong tree. What happened, happened because more than one of you decided you wanted to get out, right? No matter how much time passes, you can't cut free of your regrets. From the outside world, you're to blame. Genie, hey, evening, afternoon. Of course, we can't cut free for the outside world, but being trapped in this insane place? You're trapped, are you? Well, I'm sure you once learned that all the mysteries at the school, your thinking would change with her. You'll think, boy, isn't this so wonderful how we all get to live here forever?
What does this mean?
What are trying to say?
Hey.
Look, there's some deeper meaning hidden in there. It's like before.
Thrills, chills, kills!
Any? Let's get to the Blackened's punishment. That's what everyone is waiting for, after all.
Hey.
When you say everyone, who exactly are you referring to? Sorry, I said everything I got to say. You can save some time for the fun later. Just like that, he was gone. He left us there, overwhelmed by a nightmare-turned reality. Finished chapter 9, basically. Chapter 9 of... what, Final Fantasy 7? After he was gone, he stood there forever, unable to move. No, it wasn't that long, I think. Okay. Everyone just lost their sense of time. We were all too scared. Could have been alone. No one even tried to speak. Their faces were stone, their voices dead. But it was in that moment.
Just a second.
Can I talk to you for a second? Sure. She moved in close and whispered into my ear.
Makoto.
Before we head back, I think I want to talk to you about... But Psyche, isn't it? Surprised if you figured it out.
Listen.
I told you before the class trial started, you had to figure out the mystery of this case yourself. You wanted me to realize how Sayaka betrayed me by myself, didn't you? The thought never even crossed my mind. I feel like such a fool becoming such an easy target like that.
It's true.
Sayaka meant to double-cross you. That's a fact that you can never change. But even till the very end, she wasn't sure of her decision. That's why. She lay dying, she was thinking of you. Thinking of me? You can't just say something like that. I mean, there's no way you can know that. Only Sayaka would know for sure, and we can't ask her now.
However,
even if you can't ask her, you can infer, don't you? Her final thought? It's how she could protect you. What?
So...
The fact that she used her last ounce of energy to leave her dying message proves it. If she didn't care what happened to you, she never would have left that message. Maybe she just wanted to get back at the person who killed her.
Certainly.
Certainly one possibility, but I don't think that's what it was.
Anyway...
It was uncertain. She wasn't sure she could kill someone or deceive you. That's why her plan failed. As hesitation attracted failure.
Right.
It's almost ironic when you think about it. Why are you telling me all this? Because you're the kind of person who can overcome this. Because you can move past the deaths of your friends, Saiken and Leon, and keep moving forward.
Correct.
Without someone like that, the others would never be able to break free of such a desperate situation. Move past their deaths. You... What? Huh. I'm ready to go to bed before doing what I wanted to do for posterity, but I kept the save and played to the end. Today, doubling back for everything I actually wanted to do. Playing through it, I think they did a great job fixing it. Oh, okay. Just give me pause, but I actually seen facial surgery like that, so can't complain. Oh, there you go. I could never do. No, I'm going to carry them with me for the rest of my life. I possibly move past something like this. Leon, Saika, I'll carry them with me forever. I'll carry their memories wherever I go. Instead of forgetting them, you're choosing the hard road. Well, I have high expectations for you. As she said that, she revealed the smallest smiles.
Hey.
By the way, I have to admit, I'm curious. Did you know I wanted to talk to you about Saika? Well, I'm psychic.
What?
Kidding, I just have a pretty good intuition. We really gonna do that? Chapter 1 completed! I think I got a good ending. Oh, biscuits. Down to 12, chat.
To be continued.